understood the product planning, let's understand the various terms related to product. First, what is a product item? A product item is a single product, whereas a product line is all items of the same type. And product mix is the total group of products that an organization has to offer to the market. For example, Rin, Wheel, Surf, Surf Ultra are all part of Unilever's detergent line, whereas Lesansi, Lux, Rexona, Lifebuoy are part of its soaps line. So having said that, let's understand in further detail what really product line is, which is a very important term. Product line is a series of related products, that is a group of products that are physically similar in performance, use or features and are intended for one similar market. A set of products which are very closely related, for example, Nike shoes, Adidas, Reebok, New Balance, etc. Second category could be Apple, HP, Hitachi, Mitsubishi, etc. Having said that, let's understand why firms do not want to limit themselves to one particular product. The first one being to counteract the effects of the product life cycle on a particular product firm. That is, every product goes through a life cycle from the introduction stage to the growth to the maturity to the decline stage. Every product inevitably comes into the decline stage. To counteract that particular effect of the decline, a company wants to actually come up with various products so that it can constantly be in market and be operational. Second being, to even out the seasonal sales patterns, because there are certain products which are not required in all seasons, so as yet again to be operational throughout the year, you need to be operating in several various products so as to counteract yet again the seasonal sales pattern. The third is to use the company resources and capabilities much more effectively and efficiently. Next one is to capitalize on middlemen and consumer acceptance of the established products. That is, when we already have our sources in place, that is, our consumers are already aware about our brand and we already have a good brand name in the market, why not capitalize on the same? Provide them with more products under the same brand name, which would not incur too much of advertising and promotion costs. Next would be to spread production and marketing costs over a wider product mix so as to reduce costs in the long run. And finally, to become better known and respected by middlemen and consumers. The next point would be, how do you actually modify your existing product lines? Well, that can be done in a various ways. First, the composition of product line can be changed. You can actually bring in addition or delete certain products from your product line and change the composition and modify your predicting lines. Second would be expansion or contraction of the product line. Third would be value addition process. Next is changing the brand name or bringing about a different brand mark. Next, changes in the packaging. Difference one would be physical characteristics. And finally, positioning, which is making sure that your product or your service holds a valued and a distinct place in the minds of the customers.